Hey guys, welcome to Programming Knowledge. In this video, we'll discuss about how a program actually runs, what compilers and interpreters do, and what are the differences between them. For a recap, this is the program provided by the CodeBlocks IDE. I just changed the default hello world statement to this statement. And then once you press this button or the F9 button, you're going to execute this code and the console is going to pop, which is going to print welcome to programming knowledge or whatever statement you typed inside the double quote, and then it is going to return the execution time and all these things. Let us see what is actually happening in the background. Understand that first we need to understand what are the types of languages in computer programming. There are three major kinds of languages that are machine language, assembly language, and the high level language. Machine language is the fundamental language of the computer's processor. Computer is not going to understand any other language than the machine language. All programs are converted into machine language before they can be executed. And machine language is just a series of zeros and ones that represents low and high voltage. Coming to assembly language, it is also a low level language that is similar to machine language. But the difference is that assembly languages use symbolic operation code to represent the machine operation code. Both the assembly language and the machine language are almost similar to C, but the only difference is that assembly language are bit human readable than a machine language. High level languages are what we are learning. C++, Java, Python, all these are high level languages. They use English like statements, and every statement in a high level language consists of set of low level statements which are running in the background. Let's look at an example. So this is a simple program to do a mathematical computation. Let's not get into the details of it. The only thing we need to understand is that the computation which is going to be performed is b into h by 2. That is, the contents of b is going to be multiplied with the content of h, and then the result is going to be divided by 2, and that is the value we are going to get. So what happens in the background is that first memory location with the size of memory required for this particular object is loaded into the memory, and then the contents of B are transferred into the location R1. Same thing happens with R2. Then R1 and R2 are multiplied, the contents of R1 and R2 are multiplied, and then the result is stored back in R1. Next statement here divides the contents of R1 by the number 2, and then the result is given back to the memory location which is requesting the computation. All these temporary memory locations which have been created are then unloaded from the memory to be used in a different process. So this is what happens in the background of this simple computation. So in case of our hello world program here, or the welcome to programming knowledge, this one, what happens is that first a link is established between the console and our program, and then there is a process which will generate machine code from this particular code, and then that is going to be executed, and what we see as a result is this statement on our console. So there is a lot of process going behind. Let's see what a compiler is. So as I told you, compiler is a piece of software that translates the high level language to the machine level code. The compiler basically takes the source code and then it converts it into the executable code. This step is known as a pre-processing step. And then the executable code, which is the zeros and ones, or sometimes assembly code, are converted into the machine code, which is purely zeros and ones. And then this code is executed by the machine. So compilation step consists of two steps, pre-processing and the processing. So a compiler takes a lot of pre-processing time. It is going to go through the whole of your program. It is going to read each and every statement. It is going to list all the errors, and then it is going to ask you to correct the errors. It is again going to review your program, and then it is going to finally generate the executable code once it finds out that there are no grammatical or syntactical errors in your program. So this is how the compiler works. First, the source file is loaded into the compiler. This is a case of generating multiple objects, that is compiling multiple source files. But in our case, we only have one source file, that is this main.cpp file. This is a source file. If we try to compile more than one source file, that is also possible. We will be doing that at a later stage. So once it's loaded into the compiler, it is going to generate the low-level code, that is the object code. Object code goes by the extension .obj in C++, and then this obj file is loaded into the linker, and then it's a runtime library. We will discuss about these things at a later stage, and then these linkers and libraries help convert the object file into the executable program, which we get as a .exe file, which we can run by double-clicking it on our computer. So what an interpreter is? Interpreter is same as a compiler. There is not much difference. The only thing is that in interpreter, the pre-processing step is faster than the case of compiler. In interpreter, the interpreter is going to go through each and every line of the code. It is going to execute that particular line in a virtual environment. And then once it encounters an error, it is going to stop right there, and then it's going to ask the programmer to correct the error. So once you correct the error, the interpretation process continues from that particular point to the end. That's why interpreter is faster at pre-processing, and then it doesn't generate an object file. Object files are generated in the runtime itself. That is why the processing time is big, because while executing the same program multiple times, every time at every execution, an object file needs to be generated on the runtime. Unlike the case of compiler, where only one object file is generated at the first time of compilation, and the same object file is used to run the program. That's why if we see this, if we change anything here, if I make welcome to programming knowledge as the default hello world, and if I just run this program, I'm just going to get welcome to programming knowledge. Why did this happen? Because the object file is the same in this case. In case of an interpreter, that is going to change. If you directly change this code here and then run the program, you are going to get hello world in place of welcome to programming knowledge. To get the hello world, we again need to generate the object file, which is clicking this button, which says build and run. That is why we click F9 or build and run, because every time we change the code, we need to generate the object file. Generally, it is going to give the desired output, or else it is going to work on the previously generated object file. So once we create this build and run, click on this build and run button, we are going to get hello world here. And now again, if we click on this button, which just says run, you will get hello world, because the object file has been replaced now. And then, if we make any changes wrong, if we just type hello here and then again click on run, it is just going to say hello world. That's how an object file works. Compile time and runtime. These are some of the confused terms. Compile time is the time taken to compile a program. Compile time is hardware dependent. Runtime is just the time taken for executing a program, and it is not hardware dependent. So if we are checking the efficiency of a program, we need to check the runtime of the program, not the compile time. Because in a computer with higher specifications, compile time will be much faster than a computer with lower specifications, but the runtime of both the programs is going to be same. Next thing is that the source code and the object code are often confused. Source code is the code which we run. Source code is the .cpp file which we wrote here. This is the source code, and then the .obj file which is generated, or the object code which is sometimes generated in some language and sometimes is generated in the runtime. They are the machine code, and that is low-level language. We cannot directly read the code unless we have an assembly language editor. The differences between interpreter and compiler, they are almost the same thing, just the working of the both differ. First thing is that as I told you, compiler translates the entire programming statements and then executes it later. It forms the OBJ file, and then interpreter first takes the code line by line, and then it is going to execute it in a virtual environment immediately. It is going to look at the result, and only if that particular line is correct, it is going to go for the compilation. Next thing, object code is generated in compiler, whereas in interpreter it is not generated. It is generated during the runtime itself. Third thing, which is the most important thing, is that the runtime of compiled languages are much faster than interpreted languages. This is because compile core makes only one OBJ file, only one object code, which is used to compile it again and again. In case of an interpreter, is generated during the runtime. So every time an interpreted code is run, an object file is generated in the runtime and that is going to be executed. So we are comparing the performance of C++ and Python. Python is an interpreted language. C++ will perform much faster than Python because of the OBJ file which it is going to save on the disk. Python is not going to save the OBJ file, it is going to generate the OBJ file every time it is executed. So that is the difference between interpreter and compiler. In the next video, we will be looking at the code. We will be exploring this code line by line and we will look at what each statement means. That's all for this video. Thank you.